Okay, so here's another one of these movies that Seven wouldn't do. But anyway, here we go. Test review, final exam review, actually. So here's the first few pages. I've given you zillions of reviews. All right, here we go. There's the plan. We'll finish Foxtrot 2. I'll issue the practice exam. We never did do the instructor evaluation. Okay, so here's the plan. Okay. And there's the rules of engagement, exam policies, you know, all stuff, right? Make sure you're here on time. Let's see, we did all this on Friday, so that's a different movie. That's a different movie where I did all this stuff. And we had a little bit of fun here as well, function graphing. Right? Turns out that it's a really interesting thing, this recipe, this formula, but did you know that the length of a spring depends on how much weight add to it? Isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing? If you double the weight, the spring stretches twice as far. And of course, if it's already a 4, because it's got a length to it, then it just, it's kind of interesting. So you're just going to plug in some numbers. So if you hang 0 weight on a spring, it's just going to stretch 4. If you hang 10 grams on this spring, it's going to stretch, well, 0.3 of 10 is 3 plus 4 is 7. 7 what? Centimeters. Oh, good. How about if we hang 20 grams? Well, gee, it stretched 3 last time. It's going to stretch another 3 is 10. And after a while, you start to realize that every time you add 10, you add 3. Add 10, add 3, add 10. Add 3. Oh my goodness, how many times are we going to do the same slope or rate of change, as we call it? Boom, right there. That turns out it makes a pattern. That's called a line. All right, same thing here. Have you ever noticed that when you drink pop or sodas, that the calories you get depends on how much you drink? So it turns out there's a secret calorie counter thing. So they know that the number of calories you get is 14 times, there's hidden times in there, the number of ounces, right? Ounces are, well, shots. It's what we used to use in the old days. It's, 28 milliliters or something. All right, so let's see what happens. Let's calculate the formula. All right, it's a secret recipe or a function. 14 times nothing. 14 times nothing is nothing, right? How about 14 times 10? Looks like about a 140. How about 14 times 20? Gee, how about if we just double that, call it 280? How about 14 times 30? I'm betting that'll be 420. I'm just going to add another 4, 140. So notice I go up by 10, I add 140. I go up by 10, I add 140. That's called the linear pattern. Every time you take one step to the right, it goes up by the same amount every time. That would be called a line, or a constant rate of change, or a slope. Alright, turns out that's what we call it. And when you connect the dots, it makes a pattern. It's called a, let's see, what do you call a whole bunch of dots going in the same direction? I think we call that a line. Boom. There you go. Line. Next slide. Now, not everything is a line. Check this out. All right. If you tumble off a cliff, so you're on a 144-foot cliff, and you drop a rock, sure, like the Tallahatchie Bridge. Where is the rock after a certain amount of time? Well, guess what? After 0 seconds, notice this is an exponential equation. We did this, disregard. All right, so let's do the formula. It's like an upside down exponential. Notice it's got an exponent there. It's got a square power. This is called a power. So it's a power equation. You haven't graphed anything with a power in it before. So it's probably not going to be a line. Let's see. So let's plug in some numbers. All right, let's plug in 0. So 144 minus 16 zero zeros. What's 144 minus 16? 0 times 0. I'm thinking it's 144. Boom. How about if we plug in a 5? Where is that rock going to be after half of a second? Let's plug that in. So for the time equals 5, semicolon there, 144 minus 16, half-halves. Well, a half-half is a quarter, isn't it? So it's not going to be more. It's going to be 140. Did you need a calculator to do that? Maybe. It's a good idea to practice evaluating in your head, too. How about 1? All right, so after 1 second, where is the rock? 144 minus 16, 1 1s. Well, that's going to be 128, isn't it? 144 minus 16. So notice you always do the squaring first, the squaring first. You always do exponents first. So 128. Let's keep going. Let's try it for 1.5 seconds. All right, so where is the rock after 1.5 seconds? Well, it started at 144, and it loses 16 times 1.5 squared. That's 2 1/4, 32, 36. So it's going to be 108. Perfect. And you just keep going. All right, you can do those. And when you plot it, look what you get. So I'll finish off the last ones here. 2 seconds, 2.5 squared. What happens at 3 seconds? 3, 2, 1, splat. Boom. There you go. You just hit the water or the ground. And here's what it looks like when you graph it. Notice it's not a line. Well, it won't be a line because there's a square in here. So this is what it looks like when a ball falls off a cliff. That's pretty much it. It's not a line. All right, next slide. And here's some more not lines. I'm not going to waste our time doing this. You can pause this if you want. Here it goes. This is the exponential. This is like how money grows and bacteria grows and the population grows. All right, so you can pause this if you want. Check my calculations in case I messed it up. Oh, what did I do there? Okay, there we go. So check out my numbers. Let's watch this grow. There we go. 51, 76. Woohoo. Look at that. Look at her go. It looks like a line, but nope, not now. Oh man, that's exactly like compound interest. It was 150%. Next slide. There's some more lines. Let's just race through that. This was all part of your handouts. You should have done this anyways. Right, so there you are making that job, and then you switch jobs, and you make less commission, but you start at a better weekly rate. So you got a weekly salary plus a lower commission. So there you go. That's what it looks like. You did all this already. Right, here's how to do percents. 5% of 1,000 is 50. 5 per 100 of 2,000 is, guess what, twice as much. Son of a gun. Next slide. Let's do this one. All right, you were supposed to do all this anyways. Just fill in the numbers. Right. And notice the pattern here. Notice that every time you go 50 miles, you lose 5 gallons. 50 miles, 5 gallons. 50 miles, 5 gallons. All right. So if it's 1 gallon for 10 miles, then it's 5 gallons for 50 miles. How about this one? Right, this car here gets 1 gallon to go 25 miles, which means it's going to lose 2 gallons to go 50 miles. So it's going to take away 2, take away 2, take away 2, take away. I think there's a pattern here. Every time you go 50, you take away 2. And of course, gee, which one of those cars is the most fuel efficient? I'd rather have the red car. I was only worried about gas, because you can go further with a little bit of gas on this one. Next slide. We did that the other day as well. This is all repeat. We did all this before. Let's just race through this. All right. I give you a couple X's. You plug them into the recipe. You calculate the Y's. Bob's your rent. There you go. Plop the dots, rather. So 4, 3. Boom. -6, -2, boom. negative 2, 0, boom, and 0, 1 right there. Connect the dots. Look at that. Makes a nice line. Isn't that nice? We did all this the other day. All right, I'll want to try this one. All right, we did this the other day. This is all repeat. Pause it if you don't like the speed of this. 2, 3, negative 1, 9, 5, negative 3, and 0, 7. There you go. Next slide. All right, here's our final exam practice. All right, here we go. Right, we never learned this, so we'll omit this for now, although it's not that tough. Right, if something goes up 3 for every 8, then we... Right, so if something goes... Oh, I'm sorry, that's not what it says. Right, it says the slope of a line goes from 3 to 8 as you move 4 units to the right. So you go 4 to the right, and it was at 3, and it goes up to 8, right? So this was at, went 4, and it went to 8, so it must have gone up 5. If you go from 3 to 8, you must have gone up 5. So it's just a triangle. So we'd call that 5 over 4. We'd say the slope at a 5 over, well, it's actually exactly the same as a tangent, for goodness sake. If you know how to do a tangent, you know how to do a slope. But you know what? We didn't get much chance to talk about that, so we'll omit that. And we omitted that unit too. How about this one? All right, here's some relationships. Here's some linear relationships. Well, it turns out right away this one is not a linear relation. Notice how you go up 5, it goes up 50. Then you take another step of 5, and it goes up 40. Then you take another step of 5, and it goes up 35. So this is not a linear relationship. Whereas this one is a linear relationship. So this one is not. Notice Sam here. Sam goes up 2. Jason goes up 2. Sam goes up 2. Jay goes up 2. Up 2. He goes up 2. Every time Sam goes up 2, Jay goes up 2. Isn't that amazing? Every time he gets 2 years older, his friend gets 2 years older. That's amazing. How about this one? All right, number sequence. This is called an arithmetic sequence. We don't study them. Too bad. They're fun. So, look at that. One step to the right goes up 8. One step to the right goes up 8. One step to the right goes up 8. All right, so where was I? I just had a call. I'm sitting in the office working late for you guys. So one step to the right, up 8. One step to the right, up 8. One step. So I'm thinking that's what you call a linear pattern. Every time I go 1 to the right, I go up 8. That would be linear. Now this one here isn't exactly linear, but you know what? Nothing's ever exact. Alright, so we're talking about this one here. Let's go to this one. Now, nothing is ever exact, but notice it has a linear trend, right? It's, you know, not everything's perfect. Maybe some of those dots are off by a bit. Usually when you're plotting dots, they're not always going to be perfect. But you could certainly say this has a linear trend line, and if you're familiar with Excel, it does that as well. Alright, so turns out it's not exactly a line, but then again, what's ever exact? Next slide. And this one's pretty easy. Just Sokotoa. So which one of the Sokotoa are you going to use? Opposite over hypotenuse, adjacent over hypotenuse, opposite over adjacent. Well, label them and find out here. Well, there's your angle. Let's call it A. Right? That's not A for adjacent. That's corner A. So don't confuse that with A for adjacent. Sorry, I shouldn't have used two of the same letter. So that's the hypotenuse. It's always the hypotenuse. Across from the 90-degree corner. Boom. Enemy. And this side here is going to be the opposite side. So clearly we don't want the tangent because we don't know the adjacent side. But we do know the opposite and the hypotenuse. We want to know the hypotenuse, and we're told the opposite, and we're told this. So we're told three parts of this triangle. We're told this corner. Told this height, and we're told this corner here is 90, so you can figure it out. So it's going to be sine, because that's opposite hypotenuse. Opposite and hypotenuse. Sine is the opposite divided by the hypotenuse. And then, of course, all you're going to do is you're going to, I don't ask you, rather, to do this, but if you had to actually calculate the length of the hypotenuse, it would be that. So you just do that calculation, whatever it is, sine of 38 has got to be 0.65 or so. That'll be like about 30. Next slide. All right, calculate the slope. Now here's another slope question, which we never did. But you know what? It's not that tough. A slope is a tangent. If you can calculate the opposite over the adjacent, then you're calculating the slope, for goodness sake. Right? So you'd say it was 4 over 12, but you only look at the ramp part. You only look at the part that has a slope. So you had to realize that if that was 3 and this was 15, then this part here was just 12. And that's all you do. A slope and a tangent are identically the same thing. Next slide. Is this a linear relationship? How can you tell? So if you get the same change in x, every time you change the x by the same amount, if you get a proportional change in the y, right? Proportional. So for example here, every time you change the x, you get a change in y, and it's a nice constant relationship. So notice here, you changed the number of fish by 3, and you changed your profit by 10. And then now you change the number sold by 9, and you increased your profit by 30. Well, guess what? Isn't 10 over 3 the same as 30 over 9? So they are the same proportion. And if they're the same proportion, that means they're going in a line. So like that. Boom. So whether you go whether you go 9 for 30 or whether you go 3 for 10, it's exactly the same thing, right? 3 for 10. So 3 for 10 is the same as 9 for 30. It's the same similar triangle. It's the same rate, for goodness sake. All right, there you go. Next slide. Let's do this one. There, I'll just run it. You can figure this out. I got to get to curling. Come on, you can do it. That relationship. There she is. She's getting $15 times the number of hours. So if you were to make a picture of what her pay is going to be, you could say it's 15 times the hours. Boom, looks like it. And then you could get fancy and say, ooh, well, what if she got a raise? What if she gets more per hour? Ooh, look at that. So now we're going to try it, but this time she's going to get more money per hour because she must be a good worker or something. The boss is going to pay her more. Where did it go? Oh, yeah, here it comes. So there's her regular $15 an hour. Now, what happens if she gets a pay raise? She gets a pay decrease. What if she only makes $10 an hour? What if the boss pays her less because the company's going broke? Well, watch what happens. The graph's slope is going to be not as steep. She's going to have to work longer to get the same amount of pay because the slope is not as steep. It's the green line. So that's if she's only getting $10 every 1 hour. Look, 1 hour, $10. 1 hour, $10. 1 hour, $10. 1 hour, $10. Heck, 2 hours, $20. 3 hours, $30. 1 hour, $10. Oh my goodness. Okay, here we go. Now what happens if the boss gives her a shift premium? Every time she comes in, you know, because she gets called at late notice, they give her a $20 bonus. Right, so she gets a $20 bonus. What's that going to look like? So she makes $15 an hour plus a $20 bonus. Uh-oh. I did it wrong. I said she makes I said she makes $15 an hour and... I'm sorry, I messed this up. I said she starts at 15, so I calculated it wrong. I've got her getting a shift bonus of 15 and an hourly rate of 20, so I messed this up in all my haste, right? So there's what it would look like. That's what happens when you race through this stuff. So here's what it would look like if she got a shift bonus of 15 and $20. She'd start at 15 and then 1 hour, $20. 1 hour, $20. 1 hour, $20. All right? If you redo the question before I messed it up. So there's the idea. 1 hour, $20. 1 hour, $20. That's your rate of pay. 1 hour, $20. Rate of pay. Slope, tangent, rate of pay. And notice I had screwed up the question. There we go. We missed all that stuff. That was actually the fun unit. Too bad we had to leave that one out. We didn't even do two-thirds of the course, for goodness sake. I'm going to have to work you pretty hard and read 12. Right, there we go. So we did it all. This is what we would have done. Kind of fun. Get to use colored pencils. This was the fun unit. We had to skip it, too. All right. And this is an easy one. I'll just let you talk to this one. So there's the slope. Over 6, up 4. Over 6, up 4. So that's 2 for every 3, or 0.66. So this might be gasoline. Well, this is a dumb question. It doesn't say what units the volume is measured in. Right. Well, you can do all that. There you go. It's a dumb question. They don't show the units. Ooh, I like these. Now, this is more like grade 10, isn't it? How do you convert 40 meters a second to kilometers an hour? Well, you know how to do that, I hope. From grade 10, you're just going to convert the units one at a time. Meters per second, you're going to convert the seconds to hours. Boom, boom. Now you're going to convert the meters to kilometers. 1,000 of those is the same as one of those. Boom, boom. Notice your new units are kilometers per hour. Kilometers per hour. Multiply, divide. Bob, you're in. Okay, this one's kind of silly, too. Rate your SOHCAHTOA. If you're doing this stuff and you're not raking SOHCAHTOA, that'd be crazy. So we're looking for the opposite side to find the height of this building. And tan is opposite over adjacent. There's your adjacent. Boom, boom. Swap. That goes to the bottom. That goes to the top. Make sure you're in degree mode. Turns out the B is 98. So from there to there. That was the red chunk. Now let's do the green chunk to there. So that's 125 tan. Look, notice it's exactly the same as this. The only thing that changed was this angle. So it's the same formula, it's just the angle changed. So the height of the flagpole is 105 from there to there, the green bit, which means this little chunk of the flagpole is 7. But it's kind of a dumb question again, because I think there's probably flagpole here too. Otherwise, the flag wouldn't fly very nice. I don't know about you, but flags don't fly very well if they don't have pole to their side. Anyway, next slide here. SOHCAHTOA, here's the angle. Angle theta, right? This is the Greek letter theta. So hypotenuse is always there. There's the side opposite to the angle we're given. Here's the side adjacent. So angle theta is Greek. We like using Greek letters sometimes just to be different. Opposite over adjacent's got to be the tan. The tangent of that corner is equal to the opposite over the adjacent, which, funny enough, is the same as the slope. 0.231, you can look it up in the tables. So going that way is doing the tan, going that way is doing the untan, the inverse tan. So tan when you look it up that way, untan when you take the decimal and turn it into the angle. So we're untanning to turn it into 13 degrees. Next slide. All right, these are pretty good. You can handle this one now. I'll just accelerate. Formula's not too bad. And don't forget to unsquare it. Next slide. I gotta get going for dinner. The wife just called. She's giving me hell. It's gonna be your fault. We didn't have time to learn the rule to calculate angle theta, but you know how to do the cosine law. Side, side, angle in between. There you go. Plug in the numbers. My plastic brain does it very nicely. 3, 2, 1, next. We had to omit this one because we never learned that law. See, I didn't give you a side and an angle and the side next to it. You haven't learned how to do two sides and the angle that is not in between. You haven't learned that yet. All right, so let's keep going. We never learned that part. Too bad, it was fun. We never learned that part there. That was kind of fun, too. It's all got to do with art and drawing and perspective. And then, of course, you know what this is. That's like our last midterm quiz. So I like lots of multiple choice questions and stuff. And this is pretty much our midterm quiz. So you got all of these to work with tonight and the next night. So there you go. So there's a real quick 26-minute version of what we did for all of today, practicing our stuff. And there we go. Briefing is complete.